you have a loop setting on it, you can either do this, or you can switch it over now if you want to. It's wonderful to be here this morning on our some ordinary time. Obviously, ordinary time's a really weird time of the Church of England. But it's kind of that time when they think about what it means to be a Christian in everyday life without anything special. But we're also approaching Lent on Wednesday. Ash Wednesday is this Wednesday, very early. So there's a service at St John's starting at 7 o'clock, if you would like to do that. And there's also a tea time, a more reflective, quiet service on Sunday. That would be here at 6 o'clock, if you'd like to have tese as part of your Lent discipline, shall we say. We've come here today in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Our first hymn this morning is hymn number 158, Glorious Things of Thee Are Spoken, 158.
saying, the men were terrified. Then a cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud there came a voice. This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him. Suddenly, when they looked around, they saw no one with them anymore, but only Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, he ordered them to tell no one about what they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Moments ago, we heard the gospel account of the
ones who were transfigured there at that time. Well, you're probably thinking that's all very interesting if you're a theologian that isn't still awake. But then, why is the event so important? What does it mean to us today? Well, you are fellow travellers along Christ's path. You are welcome to the Mount of the Transfiguration. You see, the early church fathers understood the real impact of the story of the Transfiguration because it's about the grace of God and the grace of God's effect on each of our lives. For it was by the operation of God's grace that the disciples Peter, John and James were able to see Christ in a new and deeper reality. God's grace had transformed or transfigured them. And the holy and Catholic small C church is seen as the repository of God's grace that offers us the same mountainside view of Christ, but in this day and age. For those who may remember their baptism, we receive God's grace, and while other than being slightly damp, there is no external transformation, but there is and should be a wondrous and inexplicable inward transfiguration or change. As God has given us his church, in which both the spiritual birth and the further spiritual growth
things that we have done wrong, but it is through Christ who redeems us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we give you thanks for sending our Son, that no matter how far away we have drifted from you, you are ever there to welcome us home. Whatever direction our lives have taken us, whatever things we have thought or said or done, you offer us forgiveness. We ask you, Lord, to help us to model this behaviour in those people we meet around us, that we may show love and forgiveness to all. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. Lord, we give you thanks for this church and all the things that it has been a part of this community for nearly 200 years. A beacon of hope in darkness. It stood through many things, many virus outbreaks, cholera, COVID. And yet it still stands here, Lord. We still gather here offering our prayers to you. Help us, Lord, though, to not just sit here praying, but to take your word into the streets around, so that others may know of the love and hope that awaits them in you. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. Lord, we remember at this time all those people who are struggling with eating and eating, those people who are homeless, those people who are afraid and struggling with mental health problems. Remember those people who are scared to go outside. Remember those people who life just doesn't seem to make sense to them at this time. Pray your journey with them, Lord. You'll come alongside them. You'll give them a sense of peace. Remember our brothers and sisters all over the world who are gathered today and hear your word. Worship you. Some in churches, some in fields, some in underground shelters. Pray that the governments would knock at the door. We are reminded, Lord, that that was the same with the disciples, and they were waiting in that upper room with the door locked, praying for the authorities. You came and stood amongst them, and you said, "Peace be with you." We ask you, Lord, to bring peace to all those who are struggling today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our prayer. Lord, we heard a statistic recently that the NHS has 71% trust rates in our country. The Labour Party, 35%, the Conservative Party, 25%. We pray for our governments, Lord. We pray for our parties, that they will reflect the views of the people, that they can become places of trust, that they can seek the well-being of everybody in society, that they can want to lift people out of poverty, want to get people into work, have money for the NHS, have money for our arms and uniform services. We pray, Lord, that you will give them wisdom in how they make their decisions around policies, on finance, on immigration, on schooling, on healthcare. We remember at this time of King Charles, as he has recently received the diagnosis of cancer. We offer a prayer specifically for him today, but we also join and pray for other people who are struggling with cancer. We know there is no age limit to it, Lord. Whether it's young or old, the illness is industry. We know it has torn families apart. We know it, the word brings fear to those who hear it. So, Lord, we pray for your healing on those who struggle particularly with our illness today. We pray you'll surround them with love and peace. Encourage them, Lord, today. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we know there are many who are sick at this time, who are known to us and unknown to us. We remember John Hill, Joan Robbins, Rose Ashton, Estelle Baker, Joan Evans, and Elizabeth Reardon. Lord, the list gets longer and longer, but your grace increases too. We just pray, Lord, as that lady reached out to the power in the story, she touched the edge of your cloak, and your healing is flowing through. So as we reach out to you this morning, Lord, we pray your healing touch will descend on all those who need it. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Finally, Lord, we remember those who have been lost from this world. We remember the friends and family of Dave Gulliver, and we remember the friends and family of Derek Shaw. We pray for each one of those families as they come to terms with this grief. We ask you, Lord, to bless them in this time of uncertainty, to help them to keep their eyes on you and know that there is a better place to come than this world. And for those who pass, may they rest in peace
and rise in glory.
Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen.
We stand, if you are able, for our deeds. Lord Jesus Christ stood in that upper room as he came to his disciples. And he said, "Peace be with you. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace." Our next hymn, "Don't Shout."
clothes upstairs with a ham or cheese cob. If you're really lucky, you might be able to have both. Maybe. He's not looking at me. So there'll be a quiz on Tuesday evening starting at 7 p.m. Taser here at 6 p.m. on Sunday evening. And I think there's communion on Sunday this week.
Judy's here, I think.
Yep, Judy's with us at 10 feet.
Thank you to all those intrepid explorers who were on the walk yesterday. It was what we would call an adventure. Seeing as the River Severn had risen over the footpath that we were using. That was interesting. We got a bit funny. Next walk is on the 9th of March, which will be in Wombourne. So it'll be the Wombourne Canal and the Wombourne Railway, with a short stop at the old railway station for a coffee or tea. It will be led by our intrepid second explorer, Kate. She does know. So I shall be down in Worcester, I'm afraid, on that day. So look out for information next week, the walk will be on the 9th of March. For those who may wish to go, our brother in Christ, Derek Shaw's funeral, is going to be held at St Andrews, but unfortunately not this St Andrews, it's the St Andrews in Shiftel, on Thursday the 22nd of February at 3:30 in the afternoon. I am going, if anybody would like a lift, but I'm not going to sue a lift, so there's a couple of more spaces in my car if people do want me to go. Margaret's birthday was yesterday.
Busted.
And Martin's is tomorrow.
Equally busted.
And Sally's is tomorrow. So we have three lucky people who have now been counted on live stream. So people probably make a note of your birthdays and we'll send you a card next year.
We're doing it, Margaret, Martin.
Margaret, Martin, Sally.
We're doing our best for
thank you, my
service, have a chat, have an answer, not for too long, we just want to get up. It'd be great to celebrate, wouldn't it?